Hello, my friends, and welcome back. In this episode, I will test and compare 4 types of Peltier modules because I received a lot of comments about them. I also have a few projects on my to-do list for the near future with these modules. So, let's see which is the best Peltier module for your project. This video is sponsored by my patrons. I want to thank all my patrons for their support. If you want to see these videos a few days earlier and more DIY videos and updates about my future projects, please check out my Patreon page. These are the Peltier modules I will test today. Tech1-12706, it's the most used. So let's start with this one. 06 mean that it can handle maximum 6 amps at 15 volts. When you connect the module to a power source, the written side cools down, but the back side gets very hot. To keep the module cold, it needs a very good active cooling on the back side. So I put together a big aluminum radiator and a cooling fan with some long screws, so that it has a good airflow when it will be placed on the table. The fan has a current consumption of 90 milliamps. I will add this insulation foam around the module to help it maintain the temperature difference between the two sides. It has a sticky side, so it's easy to apply. I will make 2 small cuts for the wires. The Peltier module and the fan will be connected to the power supply with some short and thick wires. On the cold side, I will use a digital thermometer to measure the temperature of a small radiator. For a good temperature transfer, I will add a small amount of thermal paste between the module and the radiators. I also made this foam cage to shield the cold radiator from the flow of warm air coming from the fan and the hot radiator below. I will power the Peltier module with my ATX power supply. At 12 volts, it starts with a current consumption of 3.8 amps, which is slowly decreasing. But these modules can be powered with up to 15 volts, which will result in higher current consumption. I will fast forward the video so you can see the temperature decreasing. It took 1 minute and 3 seconds to drop the temperature of the small radiator from room temperature to 0 degrees Celsius. After half an hour, the average current consumption is 3.47 amps without the fan, and there is a lot of condensation on the radiator. And this is how it looks after a total of 60 minutes. There is very little ice on the radiator and the temperature decreased to only minus 3.6 degrees Celsius. Okay, it's time to remove this Peltier module. Whoops, be careful with the dripping water near the power supply. The strange thing is that it was colder after 30 minutes than it is after 60 minutes. This is probably because the back radiator is getting hotter over time from the high current consumption. Next is the 05 module. I already soldered the wires. I just need to apply some thermal paste. The foam cage also needs to be attached. And the thermometer. And now we start the same test. From 23 degrees to 0 degrees Celsius, it takes 53 seconds. It's a little faster than the previous module. After 15 minutes, we have ice on the small radiator, so already this one is better than the 06 module. 30 minutes have passed and we have minus 7.5 degrees and 2.57 amps. We finish the test with minus 8.8 degrees Celsius. So far, the 05 module is better than the 06 one, but we still have 2 more tests to do. The 04 module is next, but it's a little smaller than the others, so I will add a small piece of foam to insulate the radiators. Well, in 1 hour, this small Peltier module can create a lot of ice, and it dropped to minus 15.5 degrees. That's impressive! And now it's time for the final test with the 12703 Peltier module. From room temperature to 0 degrees, it takes only 30 seconds, and it keeps going fast. In 5 minutes, we already have ice. This is how it looks after half an hour. And the test is finished with minus 19.6 degrees Celsius and a lot of ice. If the cold radiator is mounted in a closed box, it will definitely get even colder.
So obviously this is the most efficient Peltier module. It can deliver the lowest temperature and the current consumption is also pretty low compared to the other modules. I know that the 06 module is cheaper and easier to buy, but it's rubbish. It has a higher current consumption, it produces a lot of heat in the back radiator, and the cold side is actually not very cold.
I like this module so much that I recorded again 30 minutes of freeze time, which I compressed for you in a few seconds. Pretty boring, right?
So, thank you for watching this short episode. I hope it's useful for your future Peltier projects. If you like this video, please share it, leave a comment below, and click the subscribe button. Bye!